Ready? Sean Fitzgerald here from Observe What Is. I'm interviewing Gustav today. He's from Fair Deal. He's the owner of Fair Deal, and we're going to be this video is going to go under the playlist for business owners, and we're going to be discussing his business and his tips and suggestions on his business. Just an intro from yourself, Gustav. Your name, your full name, your age. Are you married? And a little bit about yourself.
All right. Yeah, my name is Gustav Panzetro. I'm 44 years old. I'm married. I've got 8 year old. Born in Pretoria. Grew up in Nell Street. And I spent the last 8 years in Durban. First in Pinetown, and I'm down based here in Durban North.
Thank you, Gustav. What is the nature of your present business, Fair Deal? What do you do?
Well, we basically supply to the building trade. We supply on windows and on doors, but not just in aluminium. We do the whole spectrum of timber and aluminium.
Okay, great. Have you ever owned a business in another field or another business besides Fair Deal?
I haven't, no.
Have you worked at another company?
Yeah, I've been involved in a lot of things, mining supplies. I've been in the liquor business for a long time, so yeah.
So why did you start, as compared to your other businesses, why did you start a business in this field?
Well, actually, I came across this business through my family. It's a franchise, at school I was involved with woodwork, and I thought, we basically started with the timber windows first before we got involved in aluminium. And I thought it's a nice line to get into.
It's a good business for you.
Yeah.
What were some of the challenges that you had starting a business? Just stare at yourself. Yeah. What are some of the challenges you had starting a business in this field?
Well, first of all, capital is always a problem. Experience, a lot of things that you need to learn. Getting yourself organized, structured, getting the right people involved with you. There's a couple of things. So, yeah, there's a couple of challenges.
I picked up on something there. You spoke about capital. What on the top of your head, what would it cost somebody to actually start a business in your field from scratch? Just the top of your head.
It's complicated in the sense that we've got a central factory that supplies us. So we don't have any setup costs there, but you've got to buy into the franchise. So depending on what your cost is going to be on the franchise, you still need a capital to keep yourself alive for the next 6 months to get yourself going. So yeah, I would say a business like this, 1.5 million at least, to get yourself going.
I did hear that you said you're a franchise business?
Yes, we are.
Okay, and you're the franchise, the person that bought the franchise?
No, I'm not. I'm just own the Natal area, the KZN area.
Okay, brilliant. What are the present benefits to you in terms of freedom? Say what you need to say about that. In terms of owning your own business, what are the benefits?
Look, I mean, yeah, there's most probably a little bit of freedom involved. You can come and go like you want to, but saying that, we don't, it's such a intense business where you have to be hands-on that you can't really, you can't stay away for a week or more. I mean, it's a problem. So, the nice thing about it is being in the building trade, we've got our break in December, which we have to use. But I prefer that way in any case. So, yeah.
No problem. I'm going to ask you a question now. Would you ever go back and work for somebody else?
That's going to be difficult. Let me tell you, I've been doing this now for the last 13, 14 years. And it will be very difficult. It will be difficult.
Yeah, no problem. Okay. That's what a lot of the business owners say. Once you've been able to work for yourself, it's difficult.
Difficult to take instructions.
I think this is the biggest
problem.
Yeah. We're used to being our own boss, and now somebody else is telling us what to do. We don't want that. I know. This is the most difficult for myself, it was the same. Okay, what are the present challenges do you have now to keep your business running? I'm talking about staff, capital, money.
Yeah, look, I think the main thing, we've been in the business for a long time, like I've said. I think the big problem here is the quality of let's say, labor is a problem, in the sense that we don't have quality artisans anymore. So building is a problem, and you know, building sites are a problem. Installing, getting the right installers is a problem. So yeah, we've got problems.
So and also, so that's actually very interesting to hear that. So in fact, our productivity is not what it used to be.
It's not at all. You know, the younger generation does not want to get involved with this. They don't have the experience, and the older generation, you know, that's got the experience, they on their way out. So yeah, it's really a problem.
So you say the younger generation is not really wanting this.
No.
Is it because of the computers now, or internet?
I think so. Yeah.
It's they don't want to get their hands dirty.
It's hard work. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Is this a growing field? I mean, is there a place for this field?
Oh, there's definitely a place for this field. You know, like I say, if you can to get quality artisans is a problem, and people are prepared to pay for it.
But nobody wants to do the work.
Nobody
that type of
work
anymore.
That's the thing.
Okay. Would you? And this is my one of my questions now. Would you recommend your type of business to a person?
Look. I don't think it's a business where you need some experience, where you need to gain some experience. So if you want to get involved in something like this, you will have to gain some experience somewhere before getting involved, because there's a lot of loopholes. And if you don't have the experience, you're going to get in trouble. The thing is, we deal with house owners, with, you know, windows in a house is an expensive commodity, so, you know, you can't afford to make mistakes.
No, thank you, Gustav. The future prospects of your business, growing fields,
yeah,
will
look,
there
I mean,
still need for this?
Yeah, there's a lot of developments up and going. You know, if you look at certain areas, we can see that, you know, for future, there's a lot in the pipeline.
Okay. All right. I'm getting to the part now, tips and suggestions from yourself, as an experienced business owner who knows the ins and outs of running a business. For a person wanting to start from school, and also somebody who's got a bit of money, what suggestions would you give to a person to run a business, to start one and make it successful?
Well, you know, it's difficult to answer that. There's a lot of things involved. But the first thing I would say is you've got to be structured. You've got to have the right people around you, get your paperwork in order, make sure that you're in control of the business. That's the important thing. Once you've got that going, you know, then you can start focusing on other stuff.
And what would you recommend a person do in order to do that? How would they? What they do? They need to first go get capital. What would they? What would they do?
Think in terms of maybe your
own business too.
I think you've got to ask around. You've got to look at people that's been in the business. I'm sure there's people out there that, you know, that's willing to give some of that info. You know.
To help you.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Anything else that you want to add, Gustav, on what we've discussed that I maybe haven't covered?
Look, it's a tough economy, so this is probably not the best time to get involved in the business if you're not sure what you want to do. You know, you can't just test the field. You've got to be sure what you want to do. It is tough out there, and I think it's going to be tough for a while still.
I'd like you, and I brought up a very interesting, your answer is very interesting. Is the economy, was it better a few years ago, or is it just tough all the time? I mean, what is happening?
No, look, building trade's always been up and down. You know, they talk about the 7 or 8 year cycles, but why I'm talking about being it tough now is the fact that we've got load shedding. There's a lot of things that, you know, yeah, that complicates the matter. So it's not so much the building trade itself, but it's what's happening in the country at this stage.
Right. I just want to explain to the viewers from around the world that load shedding in South Africa is because we haven't got enough electricity. So in large areas, at certain times of the day, are switched off for 2 hours, sometimes 4 hours.
Yeah.
I've had places that have been off for a day, and these are work districts, and so people's businesses don't have electricity at those times, and they have to use generators. So that's unfortunately what's happening in South Africa at this time. That's what Gustav was talking about now in terms of load shedding. Okay, thank you, Christoph. Let's do a little expo in your business. What makes you unique compared to your competitors?
Yeah, look, the nice thing about our business is, like I said, we started with timber, but we've been in the aluminium trade now for a long time as well. So we can offer the house owner a complete product where we can do the aluminium, we can do all the external timber doors, all the internal doors, so it's a complete package that we can offer. And all of this is manufactured under one roof at our factory, which is about 7,000 or 8,000 squares under roof.
Thank you. Thank you, Gustav. Now I'm going to get Gustav to leave his contact details. This is Fair Deal, Windows and Doors. And Gustav's going to give us the full address. He's going to give us his contact details and maybe a website or an email address, if he so pleases, Gustav.
Yeah. Look, my branch is, we cover the whole of KZN. We're based in Durban North. Our address is 672 North Coast Road. 632 North Coast Road. 632,
yes.
My email is gustav@fairdealkzn.co.za.
Contact details
is 031-564-1195.
Why don't you repeat that again?
031-564-1195.
You've got a website, you did mention your
website. Yeah, we've got a website, www.woodenwindows.co.za.
Okay, thank you, Gustav. This is Observe What Is Sean Fitzgerald. Please leave your comments and suggestions. If you like the video, Gustav spent a bit of time with us. And also subscribe to the channel, it's free. Thank you very much. If the interview is over, just hit the red button and tell me when it's done.